Warning: the chemicals used in this video are toxic and volatile. They should be handled in a fume hood with gloves. Greetings, fellow nerds. In this video, we're going to demonstrate temperature-sensitive fluorescence, also known as fluorescence thermochromism. First, get a small quantity of copper iodide, about 20 milligrams or so, and then add enough pyridine to dissolve it. It'll form a yellow solution of trispyridine copper iodide. Now normally, this solution is not fluorescent at room temperature, but let's see what happens if we put it in liquid nitrogen. First, let me pour some in a smaller vial so it's easier to handle, and I'll attach a wire. Okay, here's our liquid nitrogen. Let me get the lights. Now I've lowered in the sample, and as it freezes, the sample will start to fluoresce. The exact reason why this happens is somewhat complicated to explain, but basically, fluorescence tends to work better when you reduce the thermal vibrations of the molecules in your sample. At room temperature, for some substances like this one, the vibrations are so great that they completely destroy fluorescence. Cooling the substance restores it. And there we have it, fluorescence of trispyridine copper iodide. But there are still more experiments to do. For the second one, we get a sample of the solution and put it on some filter paper and let it dry. As it dries, it loses a pyridine molecule to become bispyridine copper iodide. It'll take a few minutes, but it'll be obvious under ultraviolet light as the bispyridine copper iodide has a bright green fluorescence at room temperature. Just a little more, there we go. Nice bright green bispyridine copper iodide. Now freezing it doesn't change its fluorescence very much, but let's go in the opposite direction and heat it up. Let me get my hot plate here. Heat it while the ultraviolet light is on it, and it will quickly convert to yellow pyridine copper iodide as it liberates another pyridine molecule. As soon as it turns yellow, remove it from the heating or it'll decompose into copper iodide and pyridine. Anyway, this pyridine copper iodide has a brilliant yellow fluorescence. Let me get the liquid nitrogen. Okay, the most amazing thing about this substance is that it changes color when cooled to liquid nitrogen temperature. Now look at that. It now has a nice purple-blue fluorescence, and as I hold it, it'll convert back to yellow as it warms up. Let's try that again. This phenomenon is known as fluorescence thermochromism. I'm not certain what we can do with it yet, but who knows? Someone might figure out a really awesome application for this. That someone could be you. Okay, now you're probably wondering what would happen if we heat it too much. Let's give it a try. Looks like we're destroying its fluorescence as we liberate the last pyridine molecule and leave behind copper iodide and various forms of copper oxides. Let's test its temperature response. As you can see, we get a much duller red and blue glow from the various decomposition products. Anyway, so that was fluorescence thermochromism. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe, like, and comment.